ceases. Love is ended before it's begun. And too many moonlight kisses seem to cool in the warmth of the sun.
Yeah. through the years as the fire starts to mellow. Burning lines in the book of our lives, though the binding cracks and the pages start to yellow, I'll be in love with you. I'll be in love with you. Stars up in the heavens, I've been in love with you. I am in love with you.
Well, the way that we met, Kara and I, was pretty interesting. Back in January 1994, I was out doing a little church assignment, and I entered this one apartment, which I found out there had been new sisters that had moved in. Basically, I was finding out who had moved in there. Well, when I went in there, there was a pretty little blonde on the couch talking to me on the phone, but she was too busy talking the phone to talk to me. So I was hoping some other time I'd get an opportunity to talk to her.
Well, that's, I was on the phone, but I was, I saw him and I thought to myself, you know, he's pretty cute. I think I need to get off the phone and meet this boy.
Anyway, she did not meet me. She kept on talking.
Well,
later that week, after our word prayer, I was returning home, and there she was in my apartment with a friend, looking at mission pictures of my roommate. Well, obviously, I took the opportunity to stop and talk to her and make conversation. And that led up to a future Sunday dinner, in which I was basically coerced into asking someone to come over for dinner that evening after church. And I was kind of nervous to ask her out because, well, I thought she was probably too good for me or too pretty for me. But she did say yes, and that was basically our first date, a nice Sunday dinner. And after that, as I walked her home, I asked her out to see Legacy. As she would. Anyway, we didn't go see Legacy, but we still had a date. Well, time went on, and we saw each other, and we kind of felt better with each other as time went on. And
then a couple months later, at the beginning of March, Greg had a little chat with my dad.
A little chat.
And the next day, I knew that, you know, it was coming soon, but I didn't know when. And the next day was a Sunday, and we went to a fireside and heard President Hinckley speak, and then Greg suggested that we go on a walk, which is normal. We usually always go on Sunday by our Sunday walk. And we walked up by the Provo Temple and by the MTC there. And we walked up by the sign that said MTC on it. And then we walked over by a little church where you can see the MTC and the temple, and it's a really pretty view. And we were there all alone, and Greg said to me, I have a riddle or something for you.
I have an equation, a special equation for her.
That I had to figure out, and he said it's...
contains M, T, and C.
And so I thought and I thought, and finally I figured out that it was M equals T plus C. And he said, okay, now you have to figure out what that means. And I think that I didn't, did I?
No, I had
he had to tell me. But he said that it was marriage equals trust plus commitment. And he said that we already had the trust and the commitment, and now all we needed was the marriage. And then he got down on his knee and asked me to marry him.
Well, this is the scary part. I got down on my knee and I asked her, and she paused. Like it was... she was in shock. I knew she was going to be in shock that I was going to ask her to marry her. But she did say yes. Well, we're going to be married. She was going to be married.
Until the sun doesn't shine, till time stands still.
forget these wide-eyed fears. I'm here, nothing can harm you. My words will warm and calm you. Let me be your freedom. Let daylight dry your tears. I'm here with you, beside you, to guard you and to guide you.
Just hold.